thou readest me. I dreamed of perfect gardens where there were worthy shapes and swirly sounds, and I wasn't lonely anymore. I woke up from a wonderful dream, woke full of energy and hunger, and now this hunger will be still, and my emptiness be filled as I set about to build.
Let there be. Thank you.
together in the meadow, in the meadow, in the sun. Come together, everyone. Now the naming has begun. Leave your burrow, field and furrow for the meadow and the sun. Come together, everyone. Now the naming has begun. The naming. The naming.
I'll be there to provide, and in return they'll love me forever. another one. Where does music go when you're not listening to it?
Where?
What becomes of your dreams when you're not asleep?
You ask the most delicious question.
You're interested in answers to? You are, Abby.
Thank you. Yes.
What's the law for?
What do you mean, Kate?
What's the law for?
Don't need to know that.
Thank you.
Father.
Well, here I am.
Take us back again.
I've come to see my grandchildren. You've got your mother's eyes. Whose offering is this?
My grandfather.
Thank you, Mabel. Come here. You are a good boy. Jane, what about your offering? Where is it? Who made one?
I'll get mom and pop.
No, Mabel. Mabel. I won't be seeing them.
What do you mean?
I'm not here to see your parents.
We're waiting for you. We've been waiting for years. What cost you every day?
You are my children now. In you, I place my hope.
Promise that you'd forgive us and take us all back to the garden.
I'm not going back to the garden, Abel.
What?
There is no garden. A cross. Is there?
What a wonderful place this is. What work your parents have put into it. Oh, and look at this. Your father must have made this.
He did.
You should be proud of him.
We are.
Honor your father and your mother. Do what they tell you. And keep up your offerings.
What for?
King, my son. Look, I'll come back again and visit you soon. And when I do, I'll bring a gift for you. For both of you. I will bring you both wives.
Wives? Of our own? Cain!
We have to choose wives for ourselves. Cain!
I'll choose perfect wives for you. And then you can start family. And give me my first great grandchildren.
Why should we see you anyway?
You must have faith in me.
My father has faith in me.
And why don't you just come here, Mama?
Stop us from leaving.
I'm here to keep you safe.
I shoulder and cross the
How did they get here?
Thank you. liar.
Abel, is this true?
No, liar.
You call me or not?
No.
Thank you.
to me once more. Tell me what happened to Cain. It's all I want to know. It's all Abel ever wanted to know. I know you can hear me. I know it. After Abel died, I knew Cain was gone for good. But Adam would never believe it. Every day I'd see him standing in the field, looking out over the hills for a sign of Cain coming back. But he never came. I don't know today if he's alive or dead. But you're not going to tell me, are you? No. We had our second chance with that. A wonderful boy, just like Adam, naming and numbering everything in sight. At 17, he up and disappeared without a word, scared us both to death. Came back 2 weeks later with a call from some tribe over the mountains. They had 7 children in as many years, 2 sets of twins. I don't know how she manages. And then one winter, Adam died. Suddenly, no warning. Just fell over in the fields one day and didn't get up. We buried him beside the water wall. Was that the right thing to do, Father? Father? Three of Seth's grandchildren are married already. I had my first great-grandchild last year, Zora. I wish Adam could have seen her. We farm the whole valley now, and half the range of mountains to the south. But every year, at harvest time, the whole family gets together again to remember Adam and to give thanks to you, Father. Father?
Eve, my child.
Father!
Night has fallen.
But why can't I see you?
Oh, you'll see me soon enough.
Then you mean it's time for me to die?
It's nearly time.
Father, what happened to Cain? Is he alive?
Cain is alive.
And did he find some happiness?
Yes, he found some happiness.
And you, Father?
No thanks to me.
Father?
Yes, my child.
I miss you!
Oh, don't cry, daughter Eve. You have done well.
I've done my best.
You have born Seth, a strong, good life.
He's strong enough.
In Seth and his family, I place my hopes.
But Father, what if they disappoint you too? What will you do then?
No more questions, Dr. B. It is time to sleep.
Dear children, this will be my final harvest. My father has called me home.
Oh, what does she mean, my home?
Maybe the garden is still there. Maybe I'll see David.